there's one man over here. There's one man. He's hardly a man. He's a machine, I feel, because he's 24/7 doing something. We're trying to go live with him. If the light is good at his house right now, he's there. All gray.
I'm all gray. What do I do?
All gray. No, it's looking amazing, I think. It looks like...
This is the first time I'm revealing my gray to you, Varun. Because I've realized I have to just live like this. Now, there's nothing I can do. My children think that I've grown old suddenly.
I feel you're looking like a Bond villain.
Like a what? A Bond villain?
Yeah, like a James Bond villain. And you know...
Listen, the last time I played villain was in a film called Bombay Velvet. And you know how that went, right? So I think I'm scarred by playing villain altogether. I don't think that I should ever try and act firstly again in my life. How are you, Varun? Happy birthday.
Thank you so much. There's a girl on here saying that Karan looks really hot.
Karan looks hot like this?
Yeah.
Chalo, I'm so glad the girl finds me hot.
A lot of people are saying that you're looking really hot right now. New look, Karan looks really hot. Karan looks really cool. I think people are loving this new look of yours, Karan. It's working.
I've exposed my new look on your birthday for you. This is my present for you, Varun. My new look. This is my new look.
But can I know why did you decide to just go grey? What made you think that, you know, you should just like, screw it. Let's not color the hair. Let's just...
I'm sitting in the house, yeah, not doing anything. Now, who's going to color and what am I beautifying myself for? Who and what? I'm just happy. I'm with my kids, with my mom. I'm just happy with my... I don't want to like... Also, you know, you must understand, all those reasons Shashank is trying to call me. So I said, all the chemicals that keep going in our hair is not good for our hair. So I think this will be a good holiday for my hair as well. Let me age gracefully and start behaving like my age for once. My children anyway have really trolled me at home and they have said I'm looking like a Buddha. They say I dress badly. I can't dance. I can't sing. Apparently, I can't do anything. So I just decided to succumb to my...
No, you can do a lot of things. We know that. You're supremely talented. Karan, because you know, I've been going through this realization during this lockdown that, you know, I also want to stay away from things that are too packaged or too there are too many chemicals in them, and we all want to go a little bit towards the nature and the natural side of things. Is that happening to you as well?
I think more than that, I think I just want to say that the one thing that I believe very strongly is that we're all going through various shifts in our emotions and feelings and thoughts and about the environment, about the climate, about ourselves, about our lives. I just want everybody to hold on to this thought right now and not let it go away, because eventually when things will open up and we're back to a conventional, more normal existence, I don't want us to forget what we felt at this time, because what we're feeling right now is very special. It's very responsible. It's emotional. We're feeling compassionate. We're feeling responsible. I don't want this feeling to go away and suddenly we'll become like irresponsible, frivolous people all over again. I just feel that we have to hold on to this emotion, possibly write it down. Like every day, I've started doing that. I start writing down my feelings because I want to read that when things become normal, about how I felt, what I feel about people, what I feel about myself. I just feel like I don't think any of us should be the same person after this. We should all hold on to the people we were during this lockdown.
I also want to tell anyone who's watching this and everyone who's watching this that Karan, along with Dharma Productions, has been doing some really good work. They've been giving large amounts of money to very credible organizations that is helping people, whether it's the Daily Wagers, whether it's to the doctors for their kids. They've just put out a song which is for the doctors right now. It's a beautiful song. I really love the song, what you all put out, Karan. And yes, that's amazing. I know you don't kind of put these things out, which I always tell Karan that, you know, you do so many things in life which nobody knows about. And I have seen him day in, day out, like even whether it's just in the office with the staff who's like really, really old and been there for ages, he'll continue supporting them and their families. And I think a lot of businesses should follow you, I think, because the human side is what you're showing. Right?
No, I just feel like I a few things that we've learned, I think Dharma has learned from my dad, basically. He set the tone in Dharma. And he used to say that films, whether they're hits or flops, don't matter. But if you have a flop relationship in the industry, that's the big flop to really, really feel sad about. He says your relationships have to be super hits. Films can be fine as long as your relationships are blockbusters. And that's what I lived by, I think. You know, I tried to create blockbuster relationships like I have one with you. And And I think that we're all here to do our bit. Yeah, we are very tiny parts of this large planet, and we have to just do what we need to do. And I think, like you said with Arjun, and I was catching the last bit of your live chat with him, that is, it's important to smile and keep that smile going around you. And you know, we shouldn't take ourselves too seriously, because we're also selling smiles. That's what people like us do. We sell smiles. Constantly make sure we do that.
You know, it's so amazing. The person who... Your mom actually wished me twice on my birthday. One was at night and today in the morning. And what she told me both the times was that, beta, smile, keep your parents happy and all the smile. Because I think that's what all the older generation is looking, that, you know, the younger generation brings that positivity, brings a reason for them to smile during these hard times. So all the kids out there also have to do that.
Yeah, and I think, like, I think, call me, sorry. Smile so I think you have to spread that laughter and spread the cheer. And I think we're trying to do that in our own way. I've created, that's why I created this fun property at home with my babies. Because I just think that, you know, let me share my smiles with the rest of the world, because they're very funny. They say the funniest things, and they come, it comes from such an innocent place in their hearts. And I just wanted to put it out, you know, and that lockdown is also one way of looking at the fact that we're never going to get these years and days back with our families the way we are. So there is always a silver lining, and we have to look for it.
That's true. There's a silver lining. There's a gray hair, silver hair. Like, we
can, there's silver hair and there's a silver lining. And I'm sure you have many more people to chat with. So I'm going to say toodles to you. And happy birthday. And I love you, Varun. And call me after this. Call me after this. I have to discuss a couple of work things with you.
Five times. Bye. I will call you at least five times. Bye. See you.
Okay. Bye. Bye. Bye.
That was Karan Johar, who's, you know, one of the closest people to me. And since the beginning of my industry, he's really a stand-up guy, really a cool, good guy.